Now start to learn the next part, thrombosis. It belongs to abnormal materials in blood vessel. Thrombosis. Thrombosis is the pathologic form of hemostasis. It involves blood clot, that is thrombus, formation in an injured vessel or thrombotic occlusion of a vessel after relatively minor injury. Now, let's review normal hemostasis process. This is an arterial. It is endothelium. It is smooth muscle. Extracellular matrix, that is ECM, is under endothelium. Its main component is collagen fiber. Here, there is a local vascular injury. After injury, endothelium immediately releases endothelium, induce a reflex vessel constriction. Also, ECM is exposed. This picture shows primary hemostasis. Platelets adhere to exposed ECM and are activated. Undergo a shape change. Platelets release ADP and thrombosin, that is TXA2. Platelets aggregated and form the primary hemostatic plaque, that is platelet plaque. Finally, stops external bleeding. So, platelets undergo three reactions: adhesion and shape change, secretion, that is release reaction, and aggregation. Then platelet plaques stops external bleeding. This shows formation of secondary hemostasis. Tissue factor released, platelet phospholipids was activated, lead to thrombin activation and fibrin polymerization. A solid hemostatic plaque formed to prevent any additional hemorrhage. At this stage, TPA and thrombomodulin release to block coagulation cascade and limit the hemostatic process, then maintain the balance of thrombus and antithrombotic agents. In this video, vascular injury lead to vessel constriction, platelets adhered and shape changed, and secrete and aggregate. Then, the primary hemostatic plaques formed. Thrombosis is the pathologic form of hemostasis. There are three factors that influence thrombus formation: endothelial injury, stasis or turbulence of blood flow, blood hypercoagulability. Endothelial cells possess antithrombotic and prothrombotic properties. Antithrombotic properties include antiplatelet properties, anticoagulant properties, and fibrinolytic properties. Antiplatelet properties include block platelet activation, adhesion, and aggregation. Injured endothelial cells, once activated, can also become prothrombotic. The balance between endothelial, antithrombotic, and prothrombotic activities determines whether thrombus formation, propagation, or dissolution occurs. Common place of injury to endothelium are as follows: size of myocardial infarction, cardiac surgery, other plaques of atherosclerosis, traumatic or inflammatory vascular injury, that is vasculitis. Now, let's see the influence of stasis or turbulence of blood flow on thrombogenesis. Stasis contribute to venous thrombus. Turbulence contribute to arterial and cardiac thrombosis. Initial normal laminar flow. Blood cells and platelets occupied center of blood stream and was separated from endothelium by nodules of plasma, which moved more slowly. In the stasis of turbulence, normal laminar flow was disrupted. It brings platelets into contacting with the endothelium, finally lead to thrombosis. Last one is blood hypercoagulability. Blood hypercoagulability makes it predisposed to thrombosis. It can be divided into genetic hypercoagulability and acquired hypercoagulability. Common causes of genetic hypercoagulability is mutations in the factor V gene and the prothrombin gene. Common causes of acquired hypercoagulability: stasis or vascular injury, prolonged bed rest or immobilization, oral contraceptive use, state of pregnancy, smoking and obesity, disseminated cancers release procoagulant products. So, let's review what we shall try on thrombus formation. There are three factors influence thrombus formation: endothelial injury, stasis or turbulence of blood flow, blood hypercoagulability,